Welcome to week 28 of your 40-week pregnancy journey and the first week of your third and final trimester. Just 12 more weeks until you meet your baby. At 28 weeks pregnant, you have some exciting baby developments in the store. Your baby's development at week 28. At 28 weeks, the baby is size of an eggplant. Putting the layers of fat, baby now measures about 14.8 inches from head to toe and weighs in about 2.2 pounds. Your little one is now able to open and close his eyes. He may even have some eyelashes. With his eyes open, your baby is now able to tell light from dark. He may even turn or move around as a reaction to changes in light. Your baby's brain is still developing, but the central nervous system has developed enough to allow your baby to begin to control his body temperature. When you're 28 weeks pregnant, your baby's position in the womb could be with his heads facing down or both pointed down, which is called breech. Now, however, grooves and folds are forming thanks to an upgrowth in brain tissue. At the same time, your baby is already experiencing sleep cycles and can now enjoy deeper sleep complete with dreams. Your healthcare provider may be able to tell you which direction he is facing at your next appointment if you have an ultrasound at 28 weeks pregnant. But don't worry if he is in breech or another unusual position now. Over the next few weeks, he'll likely turn himself around. This could be a good time to begin tracking your little guy's movements. You may find he's more active when you're resting or after a meal. Think of counting those little kicks as one of your first bonding experiences. The sonograph this week shows that your baby's heart beats around 140 beats per minute. Your common symptoms this week. Some of the symptoms which you may experience during this week might include: Number 1. Symphysis pubis dysfunction. Symphysis pubis dysfunction or pelvic girdle pain happens when the ligaments that normally keep your pelvic bone aligned during the pregnancy become too relaxed and stretchy too soon before birth. The culprit behind SPD is the aptly named hormone relaxin, which makes your ligaments stretchy so your baby can ease his way into the world. Sometimes relaxin does its job too well, loosening the ligaments around your pelvic bone way before the baby is ready to come out, which causes instability in the pelvic joint. Number 2. Dizziness and faintedness. Early in pregnancy, your body is gearing up to meet the needs of two bodies instead of one. Dizziness is likely due to several factors such as your body is not yet producing enough blood to fill rapidly expanding circulatory system. Your growing uterus can put pressure on your blood vessels, especially when you are lying on your back. If your blood sugar drops or you become dehydrated, you're more likely to experience a dizzy spell. Number 3. Bleeding gums. Several factors could be contributing to your swollen gums and sore mouth during pregnancy, such as surgery, hormones, swelling gums, changes to your mouth and eating habits, delayed reaction to morning sickness, your newly finicky senses. Due to these reasons, your gums may also be extra tender, swollen, red, sensitive, and prone to bleeding during pregnancy, especially when you brush and floss. So here are some self-care tips during this week. Some of the self-care tips which you should follow during this week might include: Number 1. Preventing symphysis pubic dysfunction. There are some things you can do to ease your discomfort if you are suffering from this pregnancy symptom, including: wear a pelvic support belt, do your Kegel and pelvic tilts, avoid triggers, that is sit down to get dressed and avoid heavy lifting and pushing, ask for pain relief if the pain is severe, ask your practitioner about pain relievers. Try to take comfort in knowing that this too is a temporary symptom and will likely disappear after you have your baby. Number 2. Preventing dizziness and faintedness. To keep dizziness away from your body at first place, you should try out the following things such as: go slowly, don't get up too quickly when you are sitting or lying down, make the most of the munchies, that is eating a healthy, well-rounded diet during pregnancy with a mixture of protein and complete carbs, feast frequently, fill up with fluids, make sure that you are drinking enough water, which may include 12 to 13 glasses of fluids, dressing smart, which means avoid wearing tight-fitting clothes, scarves and hats, don't lie on your back, get some fresh air. Spending too much time in stuffy, overheated indoor spaces can trigger dizziness. Number 3. Preventing bleeding gums. Some simple steps that you can do to deal with bleeding gums include: get your teeth checked by a dentist, take care of your teeth by brushing them regularly and flossing them, brush your tongue as well, remember to rinse if you're suffering from morning sickness during pregnancy, eat right, make sure you get plenty of vitamin C in your diet, which strengthens the gums and helps them to stay healthy, eat healthy and nutritious snacks, and chew your meal properly. So in the nutshell, here is your week 28 checklist. Continue taking prenatal vitamins. Continue drinking about 8 to 12 glasses of water a day. Continue doing your Kegel exercises daily. Schedule a hospital tour. Thank you.
Please like, subscribe and share our YouTube channel, The Voice of Women. And press the bell icon to stay tuned for the latest updates.